What's up guys, we are back out here with the Tacoma, and today we're going to be installing a little fuse panel. Reason being is that I am tired of the spaghetti of wires underneath of my hood, and I'm running out of space to connect stuff. So this is what we're looking at today. It is called a universal 6-gang on-off switch panel system. Picked it up for $90 on Amazon, and I'm hoping that this can go right in the change holder compartment where I currently have two switches mounted. All right, let's open her up. So first things first, we got here, these look like all of the different decals that you can put onto this panel system. I'm assuming they're just stickers. Also includes some zip ties in here, some mounting hardware, and whatever that white thing is. And then the actual little metal mount that you can use to mount this to your dash. That's how they show it in the pictures. However, I'm gonna try and mount this, like I said, in that change holder thing that is completely useless, but Toyota includes anyway. Okay. So here we got, this is probably all of our fuses, if I had to guess. Yes, it is. Okay, so you can see inside there, you have your slots for the six different fuses. Let's turn that around. Six different fuses here. 40 amp, 40 amp, 40 amp. They're all 40 amps. Let's see here with 20. 20, 20, and a 30 amp fuse. The reason I bought this is because you don't have to run stuff back and forth into your cab, which I think is really nice. It's kind of an all-in-one piece, and then even better, they label each one of the connectors on this so that you know exactly what is what. And like I said, I'm trying to reduce wire spaghetti in my engine bay, and I think this will really help to clean things up a little bit. All right, let's move this aside. Oh, okay. And then here, you can see it also has a lead on it, so that's your ground, the black wire. And then here's your red lead. That'll go to the battery or something. And then we have our blank switch panel here. And you can see it comes with one long wire, so I guess this runs through your firewall into your engine bay. And again, I think this is really nice so that you don't have a million different little wires going back and forth from under your dash to your engine bay for every accessory that you add to your vehicle or ATV or whatever you're gonna run this on. All right, so we're gonna take a quick look at the instructions and see. All right, so it's one it's one page, and it tells you everything that comes in here, your control box, your panels, your splicers, your labels, et cetera, et cetera. Don't connect more than 960 watts. Maximum total current for switch panel, 60 amps and 12 volts, yada, 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 yada. You can all read this. Over here, it shows you how to assemble the back of that switch panel, the one that you put the stickers on. And I guess that's what the 3M tape there is for, and then that's that bracket there. And then underneath it here, it just gives you a very, very basic diagram of how to wire this all up. I am not going to show myself wiring this up because I am not a certified electrician or anything or mechanic or anything like that, so I don't want to be liable if you guys accidentally light your car, truck, ATV on fire. Alright, I'm gonna get this set up and then I'll come back. So here we have the setup that I'm currently working with. You can see I have a couple of airplane switches in here, and I actually have a bracket that I had picked up from Cali Raised. However, as I add more stuff to the truck, I'm running out of space and I don't really want to put holes in the rest of my dashboard in here. So the plan is to add that six-way fuse selector, or panel selector, whatever you want to call it, and try and put it into the same spot, and we'll see if it fits. On the packaging it says it measures 2 inches by 3 inches, so it should fit that space. However, securing it is going to be the trick. So let's get started. Alrighty, so here's what I'm currently working with. I had actually gotten a fuse switch panel here that has up to, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 spots on it. It's supposed to be waterproof. It says you can use it for marine applications and that sort of stuff. However, like the third time I went off-roading with this truck, everything shorted out, and I did trace it back to this panel. So it appears that this thing, it's a Blue Sea fuse switch panel, is not in fact waterproof. So that is the reason why I'm switching out for this six-way. All right, so I popped open the dash. When you do this, there are three screws you're gonna have to get to. There are two, there's one here, there's one there, and then you'll actually have to remove this plastic panel. You get one more back there. And then you can just kind of jiggle this thing out. Be very careful when you do it though, because there are these little plastic tabs, that red one that you can see right there. And if you really yank it, it's gonna break. I've done that before and it's frustrating. I mean, granted, you can order more of those on Amazon, but it's just a pain to take it all apart, put it back together just to replace those. And this is what I'm talking about when I say wire spaghetti. So I have two switches back here for my lights that I'm running. And then I also have a remote start that's shoved in here as well too. So with all of that, there's just a lot going on. And then like I showed you before, there's a ton coming out through the engine bay. So hopefully this panel will help me cut down on all of that. Alrighty, so I've mocked this up multiple times, and I think the final thing that I'm gonna go with here is I'm gonna take my original change holder that I still have, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna run the wire for this panel through the back of it. I drilled a hole in it. Let's pull that through. And then I am actually gonna mount it just right like that, and then it'll stick out just as wide as that is from the dash, but I don't think that'll be much of an eyesore. So now I have everything mocked up with the cup holder. You can see I've cut a little tab out of there. I'm sorry, not the cup holder, the change holder. I've cut a little tab out of there. What that's gonna allow me to do is actually to mount this thing in a way where this sits right on top, like that, and then it'll just hang out right there. Because I didn't wanna cut the entire cup holder because I figured that would possibly compromise the integrity of this. So again, this thing will sit on the front, and then the wires will run right through that hole that I made in the back. All right, now that we've secured this thing in here, before I zip the dashboard back up, I just wanted to show you all how I did it before I actually put any screws in there. So like I said, I had cut that little tab out. I used some tin snips so that this thing would fit underneath, and I mounted it upside down. And then now, if you take a look at this, I can undo my tripod. You can see this thing's just gonna hang right on the dash. And I think that looks so much better than those airplane switches that I had on there. Alrighty, I've got this thing all wired up, and it's kind of hard to see in the daylight, but you can see that it does in fact glow. And now I'm gonna start throwing on our stickers here. I got going on here my ditch lights, my center light bar, and then my amber for the top. And see what I go with. Alright, so as you can see, I've just finished wiring and installing everything. This thing is really easy to work with. As you can see in the back there, you have all different connectors, and each one of those connectors is numbered. So you have numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, and 3 are the top row of your switch panel that's in your cab. And then 4, 5, and 6 make up the bottom. And then for anything that you run to this, obviously your power is going to come out of there. And then your ground is just going to go to wherever you're grounding the rest of your wires. I love this because, like I said, what I'd sought out to do originally, this is reducing all of those different wires running back and forth from my cab. The only wire that I had to run was this red one here, and that comes off of the actual power line for the auxiliary fuse box, and that red line is a switched line. So what that means is that you run that into your cab to any of your fuses that are only going to be on when the truck is running, and then that way, not only is this thing only on when your truck is running, that instrument panel won't be lit up when you get out, so it won't drain your battery. All right, so let's talk pros and cons real quick. I would say, let's go with the pros first. Pro, this thing will greatly reduce the mess of wires that you have running in and out of your truck. Pro number two, it's easy to set up new things. As you can see, I had all sorts of leftover spaces so that when I want to run more things into there, I can just hook it right up. I don't have to run another switch. I don't have to run more wires back and forth from the cab. I think for the future expansion of whatever I decide to attach to the rest of my truck, I think this is great. As far as cons go, I can only think of one real con, and that's the fact that with the instrument panel, it's always lit up, meaning that even if you've pushed a button in, if it's on or off, it's always going to be the same color. So it's kind of tough to tell what's turned on and what's not unless it's dark out and you can see your lights that are running in front of you. But overall, I would say this is a great buy. I would recommend it if you're into off-roading or if you're running a whole bunch of auxiliary stuff on your truck, car, ATV, what have you. Thanks for watching, guys, and we'll see you next time.